Hi, I'm Carl Taylor, and this episode is sponsored by Squarespace. Here's my commercial photography website. It's a Squarespace one, and I absolutely love it. They're easy to set up, they look amazing, there are hundreds of templates to choose from, and they have first-class customer support. If you want one too, then use this URL and the coupon code CARL to get a 10% discount.
Okay, we're here at Panasonic's stand, and we know that their Lumix camera gives fantastic 4K video quality. They're now promoting something about extracting still frames from 4K video to use as still images. So we'll find out a little bit more about that. Hi, I'm with Sebastian from Panasonic. Hello. Hi. Sebastian. Sebastian's just going to give us a run through on the 4K capture on one of their cameras. They've got a system set up here. Tell us a little bit about this, Sebastian.
Well, basically what we're talking about here is the 4K photo function, which means we are able to take an 8 megapixel frame out of a 4K movie with 30p.
Okay.
So essentially that's 30 frames per second.
So you're extracting a still from the video footage.
Correct.
30 frames per second, pull out your favorite still.
Correct.
Okay, so a new way of shooting basically. Yeah. Rather than trying to capture one moment, you capture all of it, extract
make
the
sure
one
you,
that suits you.
And make sure you got
okay.
the perfect moment.
And this is a demonstration on how to do that?
Correct.
Okay.
So water drop photography, as you know, a big field.
Yep.
So what we can do here is get that perfect moment. You will surely miss that. If you look over there.
Yeah. Okay, so it's dropping water.
I'm sure you got that wrong. And yeah. The pictures you got, you can extract from that.
Right.
Well, look exactly like this.
Okay.
If so, you want, we can show
yeah, let's have a look at let's have a look how that's done.
So are you ready?
Yep. So you're shooting video here?
Yes.
I'm just releasing a couple of drops.
Yep.
That should it. Should be it. Yep.
Then I can play the video.
Okay.
Going to see it on the big screen.
So, video's connected to that television.
It's HDMI. I can play it. And pause at a certain moment.
Okay.
And then just
And then you can rewind step by step.
Exactly. Each picture I can look at.
Okay, and obviously this wasn't flash, this was just ambient light. So what sort of shutter speed duration are each of these frames then? Because there's a little bit of motion blur on some of those images, but these are nice and sharp. So obviously the brighter the light, the higher the frame capture here.
We have 1/5000th of a second here.
So it can record video, but with each one of 1/5000th of a frame.
Yes.
1/5000th of a second each frame. Okay. So is it possible just to quick look through the ones you just did?
That one in the picture seems to have too many drops.
Okay. Oh, there
and
we
then
go.
I say, this one is nice. Yeah. The next one. I always kind of try to look for the nice one.
Sure.
The video.
Excellent.
And this one I can save.
Yep.
And you can print that on 20x30
yep.
at 8 megapixels.
Yeah. So it's an 8 megapixel yeah, file, which is sufficient for a print that size. Well, really interesting run through on the 4K capability of that. Also great for video as well as stills. Thank you guys, thanks very much. So an interesting demonstration there from Panasonic with the still capture out of 4K video. Not the highest resolution out of 4K, but they are talking about 8K in the future, which would be giving you a much higher megabyte file than we just saw demonstrated there. Other reservations were, what were the ISO settings to capture that? What was the shutter speed per frame? Would there be too much motion blur on each frame, or can the shutter on the camera record at a much higher rate if you have enough light, which I suspect it can. Here, the light was quite low, so I'm not sure it was the best demonstration, but a very interesting concept and something I think we're going to see a lot more of in the future.